Welcome, welcome to virtual Vespers on the Lanai. We are so glad that you are tuning in. My name is Liz Levitt. I'm pastor here at Christ Church Uniting, and I'll be your host for this time of music, reflection, and community. You know, in a few months, we'll be coming up on our fourth anniversary of hosting this event, which was created in part because of the idea that music has so much power, not only to uplift us, but also to move us, to shape us, to connect us to each other, and to remind us of who we are. And because we all seem to need those same things, perhaps even more so in this pandemic time when we can't gather together, we're bringing this to you virtually so that you can take a few moments, wherever you are, to breathe deep, to drink in some of these melodies, and to be uplifted, encouraged, and connected. This month, we're excited to be welcoming back fan favorite Ethan Capone on piano, who was with us last December as part of Gentlemen of Jazz. This time, he's joined by Paul Nelson on bass and Ian Waxman on drums. They're going to bring us some amazing jazz sounds, which we hope you will enjoy. As you know, if you joined us before, I'll jump in here and there with some thoughts and words designed to give you some food for thought. As always, you're invited to take what speaks to you and to leave what doesn't. This entire experience is meant to be a gift, so we hope you will receive it that way. And now, without further ado, I think it's time to turn it over to Ethan, Paul, and Ian. Welcome.
Thank you so much. We're going to play one of my personal favorites. This is Skylark by the great Hoagie Carmichael. It goes like this. Alright, thank you very much. This next one we're going to do is by my favorite piano player of all time, and that's Ahmad Jamal, and this is Poinciana, and this is from his album Live at the Perishing. Thank you.
Thank you, guys. That's amazing. So today I just like to highlight two different poems actually by the same author. This is Craig Santos Perez. Perez, a native Chamorro of Guam, an indigenous people from the Mariana Islands. He is a professor at the English department at the University of Hawaii, Manoa, where he teaches creative writing, eco-poetry, and Pacific literature. His poetry weaves together reflections on both the beautiful and the darker aspects of Pacific life. I have been reading a lot of his poetry lately, and it's really spoken to me. I hope it will to you. I'll start with this one, a play on the fact that ocean is an anagram of canoe. This is Ars Pacifica by Craig Santos Perez. When the tide of silence rises, say ocean. Then, with the paddle of your tongue, rearrange the letters to form canoe. And a second one from Understory. To my wife, Nalani, and our 7-month-old daughter, Kai. Kai cries from teething. How do new parents comfort a child in pain? Bullied in school, shot by a drunk agent, hashtag Justin for Colin, justice for Colin. Nalani gently massages Kai's gums with her fingers. How do we wipe away the tear gas and blood, provide shelter from snipers, disarm the occupying armies? Nalani sings to Kai a song about the Hawaiian alphabet. What dreams will echo inside detention centers and cross teething borders to soothe the thousands of children atop La Bestia, hashtag unaccompanied. Nalani rubs Kai's back warm with coconut oil. How do we hold violence at arm's length when raising our hands up is no longer a universal symbol of surrender, hashtag Black Lives Matter. Kai finally falls asleep in Nalani's cradling arms, skin to skin against the news. When do we tell our daughter there is no safe place for us to breathe? Thanks, and let's get back to the music.
This next one's a classic by the great Dave Brubeck. This is called Take Five. Thank you. Okay, let's do one more before the break. We're going to do this one. This is a tune by Antonio Carlos Jobim, and it's called Triste. Thank you.
Awesome. So the other evening, I was standing at the kitchen sink doing dishes. It was about dusk, and I started hearing this odd noise outside. Peep, 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 peep. It kept on as I kept up with the dishes, and was still going when I finished. So eventually, I went outside onto our small lanai to investigate, and I found there a young adolescent chicken hopping around, obviously looking for her mother, who was nowhere to be seen. Peep, 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 peep. It was so tender. Now, she was weaving in and out of the fence and into my neighbor's yard and then back into mine. I felt a little heartbroken for her because it was obviously time to roost, and yet she could not find her family to cuddle up with. Now, as I watched, she made her way out onto a rock wall that stands between my two neighbors' houses. And because I live on the side of a mountain, this wall starts at ground level, but it quickly ends maybe 12 or 15 feet off of the ground. And she walked out there, and I watched in total suspense. I mean, this is what passes for entertainment when you've rarely left the house for 5 months. And she got out all the way edge, and my heart skipped a beat as she kind of tottered over the precipice, and it became clear to me that she planned to jump over the edge. And then She launched herself into the abyss. And do you know what happened? She flew. I laughed out loud. She flew in her very chicken-like way, but safely flapped down onto my neighbor's awning. Here I had been watching for a catastrophe, and I was so focused on that, I forgot that birds can fly. You know, I read Craig Perez Santos's poem before about holding his teething daughter while pondering the harsh realities of the world. And I offered it to you because it's been something that's really resonating with me. It speaks to an experience I've had lately of feeling I am constantly zooming too fast in and out between the micro and the macro details of life. Like I'm at home most of the time and focused on these tiny things, right? The fussy baby, the toddler snack, the Facebook live stream video won't start. And then something yanks me up to the 10,000 foot view of a world in trouble, of thousands of our neighbors affected by a plague, of our political system in turmoil, the environment in crisis. There are often times when I feel like I'm losing track of how to connect those two views. Which is why I am so grateful for music right now. Now maybe that sounds like a non sequitur, but really it isn't. Music, and especially jazz from my perspective as an outsider, is all about connecting the micro and the macro, right? It's about playing the right notes on the keys, but always keeping the broader theme and the melody in view. It's also about coordinating with your fellow players on those broader themes through you playing the correct keys on with your fingers or on the strings. When you think about it, you guys are pretty astonishing. You're giving me a lot of hope right now, so I just want to say thanks for that. You're reminding me that if we can make music, we can also do more than that too. We can do amazing and hard things on a huge scale through our small individual movements. We as humans have incredible ingenuity and courage. We have the capacity to keep the melody of peace and justice and well-being for all in view, even while we tend to the small notes of our individual situations. And so my encouragement to us today in this strange time is, let's not forget that we can fly. Let's not get complacent about what's possible to do when we work together. Let's not get so caught up in our despair that we forget how to employ our gifts and abilities, how to listen to one another and tune into one another and respond in a coordinated way. You know, I have to imagine that that chick never found her mom. And that in itself, like the many crises we now find ourselves in, deserves to be grieved. It's not the ending that we would write. But that doesn't mean it's the end of the story. It's my encouragement to us today. Let's not forget that we can fly. So thanks for helping us to do that with music and in so many other ways. And speaking of that, I think it's time to get back to our guests. Thanks.
Thank you very much. And thank you for putting into words so well what we do with jazz. And as a musician, certainly music has never been more important, especially those comfort songs. And this is definitely a comfort song for me. This is Boogie On Reggae Woman by Stevie Wonder. It goes like this. Thank you. Okay, back to some Latin. This one's by Chick Corea and it's called Spain. Thank you. All right, thank you very much. We're going to do this next song. Paul actually brought to my attention a very beautiful composer from Brazil named Guinga. And this is a song written by him, and it's called Constance. It goes like this. Thank you.
Thank you so much. What a wonderful time of music. I just want to close with these words of blessing to send you off. This is one of my favorites by Rumi. Isn't that something? It goes like this. I like it when the music happens like this. Something in God's eye grabs a hold of a tambourine in me, and then I turn and lift a violin in someone else, and they turn, and this turning continues. It has reached you now. Isn't that something? I just want to say a special thanks for our musicians today for uplifting us with your music, and this will be shared with many, and so we are grateful for your sharing your gifts. I want to thank Melody, our Vespers coordinator, who makes all this possible, Daniel, who is our sound expert, and if you can hear this, it is because of him. Also want to say a thanks to the entire community of Christ Church Uniting, who continues to support this endeavor, along with our many Vespers donors. We have made a commitment to continue to support musicians as best we're able in this difficult time, and youth. So thanks for being with us on the journey, and have a great day.
All right, let's do this one by Clifford Brown. We want to bring some joy, so this one is called Joy Spring. It goes like this. Thank you. Thank you very much.